What's going on, guys? John Cortese back here with another video coming at you live here from CTS Strength and Conditioning in Napa, California. Now, today's video is a topic that I'm very passionate about within the strength and conditioning field in relation to general physical preparation for athletes. So, I don't know if you ever heard the term GPP thrown around there or even SPP. We'll go over that in a minute. I'm going to write some definitions on the board for you in very simple terms. But the whole premise of this video today is to describe why I feel, in my opinion, athletes in general and even coaches and some parents even may be going about training the wrong way. And we're going to go over that right now. Now, it's not the fact that it's they're doing it on purpose. It's just that it's the lack of the knowing that training is a year-round thing. Versus looking at it as an off-season training thing and then you just abruptly stop. Now, I don't know if you saw a video prior that we put up about training through sports injuries, things of that nature, right? But, again, this whole video comes back full circle when you think about training as an athlete and the different phases or throughout the year based on their season. Enough of me rambling. We're going to go through this very quickly, and just so you get an idea of what I feel is the most appropriate way to train as an athlete year-round, okay? So first thing that we need to figure out is the side of the spectrum that you currently fall on, all right? I'm just going to draw a little line and an arrow here, hope you can see that. Now on this side, we've got something called general physical preparation. What's up, Jeff? And on the other side, we've got special physical preparation, okay? And we've got somewhere in the middle, more or less, all right? Most athletes tend to fall on this side over here. And they put all their eggs in this one basket right here, SPP, okay? So we want to think of SPP for things such as practicing your skills, your sport practice, batting practice, anything that relates to improving your skills as an athlete over here. So like sprinters, as they get closer to their competitive season, they're going to be doing a lot of their specific sprint practice, right? So things like top speed drills, running mechanics. This kind of stuff can be done year-round, but again, most people spend way too much time on all of this kind of stuff here without any sort of attention over on this side, and we'll kind of go over that in a second. But again, like for example, you see, like, it's a very classic thing to see a baseball player want to play travel baseball, they want to play club baseball, they want to play high school baseball, they want to have a pitching coach, a hitting coach, and it's like year-round. And this starts from an early age now. There's like so many kids that are specializing at like 12 years old, it's ridiculous, in one sport, okay? So by the time they're like 15 or 16, they've already got symptoms of overuse injury. They've got rotator cuff problems. They've got this and that. And it shouldn't be happening. All right. Softball, even volleyball. This is in every sport now. Okay. It's so competitive that there's travel ball and clubs for almost any sport you think of, which is great. But at the same time, I think people may be going about it a little bit in the wrong way. All right. Now we've got GPP, and we think of this type of stuff as typically is off-season training. So we've got our strength training, general speed work, anything that doesn't relate to your sport, all right? This is typically the weight room stuff. So we're going to write WT room. This could be a running hill sprints. Anything that enhances your physical preparation. So the stuff that we, as strength and conditioning coaches, do. We're trying to enhance an athlete's general physical preparation. So the reason why this is so important on this side, if this is enhanced, these skills will automatically be enhanced without even doing much of them. Now, that doesn't mean to say that you have to stop completely practicing your skills, because you should be doing this year-round, but it's got to be tweaked and modified based on where you're at in the season, okay? So, for example, if I have a, let's just say, I like to use baseball as an example, or even football. We'll just say football, okay? I've got a football player, and I want him to get stronger and faster in the offseason. But we don't want him to spend 4 to 5 days a week like he would in the season practicing football drills. He might spend 1 to 2 days a week in the offseason, you know, early January to April, doing light football drills, but putting most of his energy into general physical preparation. All right? Because if you spend all your time over here, it's just like churning your wheels in mud. You're not going anywhere. I mean, how are you going to enhance your skills? Like baseball players want to hit the ball further. They want to throw the ball harder. How are you going to do that by just constantly practicing your swing over and over without any raw horsepower involved in that? If you can't apply force in the ground, you're going nowhere. That's why we lift weights, and that's why we sprint and throw and jump and all that kind of stuff. We're trying to improve an athlete's ability to display force into the ground as well as absorb it. All right, so we have like a basketball player that jumps and lands all the time. Basketball is a great example of this. Basketball players will play basketball for 3 hours a day, 7 days a week, but will not go anywhere near a weight room. From my experience, not everybody in here does that, but on average, basketball players, they love playing basketball, which is awesome, but they don't like to lift for whatever reason. And again, it's not everybody, but it's just a good example from my experience. Eventually, we get them to understand the importance of doing this type of stuff, and all of a sudden, their vertical jumps go up, right? But that wouldn't have happened if they didn't do any squats or cleans or snatches or any of that sort of stuff. So we're trying, again, to improve general physical preparation to be able to, number one, enhance these skills, and number two, tolerate a higher volume of this type of stuff. That's how you get better as an athlete. The younger... Well, I like to, you know, enhance this. We'll put a little star asterisk, okay? Younger, novice, and you got elite athletes over here, okay? The more elite you are, the less general physical preparation that you might need in a given year. Younger athletes should spend the majority of their time over here. So, you know, even not even necessarily younger athletes. It could be novice athletes. It could be somebody that's brand new to weight training, who's got zero strength, flexibility or speed background, right? And it's like again, like I said, you're spinning your tires in the mud, going nowhere. If you spend all your time all year doing nothing but one activity over and over again, that does not make you a better athlete. It does not. It might make you more proficient in that movement pattern, but you're not going to have any sort of, you know, strength or like raw horsepower to back that up, right? So, again, what we do in the weight room is general. And it's also sport-specific because most sports are anaerobic in nature, meaning they don't require a lot of oxygen to fuel the body's needs for the given sport, depending on the sport. But I can almost guarantee 9 out of 10 times, if an athlete spends 6 months just killing it in the weight room right here, and they go, you know, 1 to 2 days per week of their sport practice just to maintain those skills, they'll be floored by the results, you know? Versus somebody who does nothing of this sort all year, yet all they do is practice their sport. You know, I mean, we tell our kids too, eventually when you go to college, if you decide to go that route and you want to play college sports, they're going to ask you to lift. It's not an option. You will have to lift. And even the females, no matter what sport you play, okay? So it makes perfect sense to start at a younger age to develop those movement patterns and to appreciate what strength training can do for you as an athlete, okay? So my advice, if you want to become a better athlete today, not tomorrow, like today, if you want to take the right decision, start doing some strength training and some general physical preparation stuff. Get time in the weight room, find a proficient coach that knows what he or she is doing, and just go after it. You know, figure out what your goals are, even if it's twice a week. You know, ideally, it should be a little more if you have the time for it. You know, 3 to 4 days a week is, like, perfect for most athletes. Then you still have time to practice your sport. And then it also comes down to time management. How well are you going to manage your time with all your other activities you've got going on? Doesn't mean to say that you need to quit all your other travel and club sports. But you might need to reconsider your approach to developing the best athlete you can be. All right? That's it, guys. John Cortez, CTS Strength and Conditioning in Napa, California. I hope this video made sense to you, and I hope it made you rethink maybe your approach in going about athleticism in general, and just helping your, maybe it's your son or daughter, or maybe this is you know, talking to you as an athlete specifically about your approach to training. You know, again, I coming from a long athletic background myself, I've seen the importance of what strength training can do for you. It, you know, might sound like a bias because I'm a strength conditioning coach now, but it's me looking out for the best interest of you and your prolonging your athletic career as long as possible, okay? Because overuse injuries just kill me. I hate seeing that kind of stuff, all right? So again, John Cortez, CTSGym.com. See you later, guys.